Hello everyone, welcome to the video lecturing for the subject Introduction to Aerospace Engineering. In this video, we'll start with fifth unit, that is launch vehicles and satellites. Here, first we will talk about the materials used for launch vehicles and satellites. The first thing is why we need to discuss about materials, because these launch vehicles and satellites are manufactured with so much of different or so many different materials based on their applications. Launch vehicles and satellites will undergo so many different environmental conditions. For an example, in Earth orbit, launch vehicle is moving, it's supposed to cross the Earth orbit to reach the space. So before crossing the Earth orbit, it will undergo huge amount of forces which will be acting on it, as well as if it goes outside in vacuum space, it will also undergo different kind of environmental conditions. Let us say the heat from sun from outside and the cabin pressure from inside. So these are some examples where your satellite as well as the launch vehicles experience different kind of forces. So due to that, based on their applications, we need to select or choose the materials for their manufacturing. Selection of these materials based on some of the mechanical properties of the materials, like the first one is high specific strength, high specific modulus, fabrication easier methods, and easily available materials and their service conditions. So these are the mechanical properties which are useful while selecting the materials for satellites as well as launch vehicles. And now, and some different types of materials are like structural metallic material, composite materials, thermostructural materials, thermal protection materials, and some special materials and chemicals. And these type of materials are based on the particular applications of launch vehicles and satellites. Some examples for structural metallics are 15CDV6. This is a low carbon steel for SRM case. Second one is M250, moraging steel for SRB case. Titanium alloy, this is for high pressure gas bottles. Aluminium alloys, that is liquid propellant tank engine and airframes. Magnesium, that is for upper stage structures, decks and bay. Powder metallurgy for nozzle throat. And some composites are Kevlar and epoxy, and that is for pressure vessel and adapters. Carbon and phenolic, that is for ablative lever and nozzle throats. And examples for thermostructures are carbon fibers. They are used for nose cap, heat shield, silicon ceramic matrix, that is used for hot and high temperatures. Next, thermal protection materials like carbon composite, that is used for nozzle throat, nose cone. Second one is silica tiles, they are used for space shuttles. Third one, polyurethane foam, they are using for cryogenic propellant tanks. And similarly, some special materials are like soft magnetic alloy for torque motors, permanent magnet for gyroscope guidance. Next, optoelectronics for photovoltaic devices. Next, electro-optics for high resolution imaging. And last one is chemicals. They are used for adhesives, bonding materials, protection, coatings. and also some rocket materials are for main frames. We can see here that is given as grade aluminum or titanium, because this has got strong, plus it has got lightweight. Then also they will use carbon composites and silica fiber tiles, especially these silica fiber tiles are used for re-entry vehicles. Thank you.